I have three roommates, and the four of us live together cooperatively. In terms of food, it means that we're sharing groceries, we're buying local food as much as possible, and our goal is to have a meal on the table 4 or 5 nights a week. When you cook with a lot of vegetables every night, you're gonna have a lot of food waste. One of the things we do is keeping a worm compost bin. The red wiggler worms don't like to eat just anything. They want food that's easiest for them to eat fast, and that means food that's not very hard, so you're gonna be feeding them leafy greens. They don't really enjoy the skins of apples or banana peels, but they will eat the apple core and the inside of a banana. Worms eat up to their weight every day. So if you have a pound of worms, you wanna feed them somewhere between half a pound and a pound of food every day. I noticed that what I feed the worms usually disappears within a week. Worms are known for being some of the fastest eaters on the planet. And when you vermicompost, you feed worms all of the extra food that you're not going to be using, and the worms eat it, digest it, and produce really valuable, really nutrient-rich compost that you can then feed back into your potted plants or your garden. You have to think a little bit like a worm when you're feeding them. Maintaining the worm bin doesn't really take up too much extra time or energy. I just interrupt my cooking for a few seconds, open the lid, and feed it some scraps. The only time that the worm bin might start smelling is if you're not doing it right. You might be overfeeding the worms, and that causes the food to start rotting instead of breaking down. If they're trying to escape, it means that they're going to withstand any sunlight to try to find more food. Worms reproduce really fast. I found out that every worm egg has 2 to 4 worms inside of it. So after 2 months, I was able to give another pound of worms away to a friend. The quality of the compost that they produce is extremely rich in nutrients that you fed it. So if you're feeding the worms high-quality organic produce waste, that soil is going to be super nutritious. And that's a lot different than the kind of soil and compost that you'd find at a garden store or Home Depot, because you know what you're feeding it, and chances are a bag of soil isn't gonna have that kind of input.